Hey guys, my name is Anuradha. Welcome to our channel GK. Guidance and knowledge. Happy morning to all of you. We are going to discuss about police reforms. Let's begin with the question. Our today's question is, political will is an essential component in bringing about any major reforms in the Indian police force. We have to comment on it. You can start introduction with polity angle and also mention the reforms. Then way forward, in which are comment included, and finally the conclusion. Significance of this question that can be asked in GS paper 2 under the heading of government policies and intervention, then that can be asked GS paper 3 under the heading of various security forces and agencies and their mandate, then judgment and cases. Our introduction would be, police comes under the state list which maintains law and order in the country. If we look at the statistics, then the UN can recommend 244 police personnel per 1 lakh people, but in India it is 144 on 1 lakh population. When we look at the women representation, it is less than 10% according to the India Justice Report 2020. With that, there are so many other reasons which shows the need of police reforms. What are the reason behind the need of police reforms? We have to discuss about it. Lack of accountability, responsibility, funding and sensitivity in the police. Then the dominance of police over citizens. Then lack of technical advancement, which is cyber security related issues. Then huge corruption and political interference. Then shortage of administrative workforce. Then slow process of investigation. 70% of people in prison are in category of under trial, which is very high compared to other countries. Like for example, UK have only 11%, USA 20%. Some sections of IPC, Indian Penal Code, consider as the colonial law. For example, section 124A, in which without proper investigation, prison is convicted for a long duration, and 326 sedition cases filed between 2014-19, but in which only 6 are convicted. Then custodial deaths frequently appears. For example, the number of cases registered between 1st April 2015 to 30th November 2015 is 25,357 under police category, in which 111 custodial deaths, 330 custodial torture included. Then lack of information and training. For example, Supreme Court strike down section 66A of IT Act, Information Technology Act, which allowed arrest for objectionable content online. But even after 6 years of its strike down, police still register cases under this section. Then what are the challenges we face? No effort made by government to make concept of smart policing in the reality. Then lack of technology and funding, lack of coordination within the police department. As per the Bureau of Police Research Development report, of 30% of stock vehicles in police system. Then lack of people friendly police. Then our way forward would be, need to improve funding and pay scale of police force. Then also increase efficiency, encourage honest and hard working police officers. We need to make promotion, demotion, suspension, removal as per their performance. Need to create sensitivity and make police citizen friendly. Then training should be done newly recruited as well as the senior service officers. Then physical checkup needed time to time. Also appoint psychologist, because police face daily new challenges, face criticism, and even the senior police officers use abusive words for lower rank police officers. Then also implement the recommendation given by Prakash Singh case 2006, which is fixed tenure 2 years for DGP, State Police Complaint Authority, separation of law and order and investigation. There is 7 directives which given by the Supreme Court. We will discuss them later. We can also follow the judgment of Andhra Pradesh High Court to establish children friendly police station to deal children related issues cases separately. Then National Security Commission needed to establish at central and state level. As per the recommendations of United Nations, police to people ratio should be increased. Also improve accountability and provide autonomy to police by introducing e-governance, technological knowledge and citizen charter, also body cams. Then implement DK Basu case verdict to prevent custodial death and torture. Then fully vaccinated the police officers, as they are frontline workers, and upgrade coordination with the police department within the police department. Also implement PM Modi vision, which is smart policing for the smart cities. S stands for strict and sensitivity. Then M for modern and mobility. A stands for alert and accountable. Then R stands for reliable and responsible. Then T stands for techno-savvy and trained. These are 7 directives of Supreme Court, which is consultate a state security commission. Also fixed 2-year tenure for DGP, 2-year term for SPs and SHOs. Also separate investigation and law and order functions. Set up police establishment board. Set up police complaint authority at state and district level. Also set up national security commission at central level. Then our conclusion would be, as said by Ajit Doval, if government implement police reforms, so our country face decreased number of crime. With the above steps and strong political will, help us to make police more efficient and effective, responsible and smart, which will help us to enhance the level of good governance in the country. What is your thinking and what are the other things which you wanted to add in this question? You can provide these things in comment section. So this is it for today. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Also provide your suggestions to improve. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.